Diaz, though Marquez is not exactly a worn down 35. He's also got a 1-inch height advantage. He's got an arm length advantage of a half inch measured from the armpit to the end of the fist. They both weighed in a half pound under the lightweight limit. Diaz has gone up only 4 pounds and Marquez only 5 pounds overnight. Rules of the bout with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Lederman.
The one Manuel Marquez, one Diaz fight is scheduled for 12 rounds using the unified rules of the Association of Boxing Commissions. There is no three knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. In case it is caused by an accidental headbutt, we go to the scorecards if the 4 rounds have been completed and you cannot be saved by the bell in any round, including the 12th and final round. Jim.
Now here's one of the most energetic fighters in the sport, Juan the Baby Bull Diaz. This is the way Diaz likes to fight.
My style of boxing is the type that puts a lot of pressure and just wears my opponents down.
Can you go with it? Can you stay with it? Round after round after round.
The Baby Bull trying to finish off Popo.
When people cheer me on for that split second after they announce my name, I get goosebumps all over my body. Now here I am in my hometown, the great city of Houston.
Fans are getting their money's worth in a huge way.
You can't bully the bull. He is just relentless.
I am the best lightweight in the world. Not Juan Manuel Marquez or no other lightweight is going to stop me from proving that to the people and to the boxing world. The prediction for tonight is pain.
Coming to the ring, Juan.
Baby Bull.
Gentlemen, you told me earlier that based on what you saw of Juan Diaz at the beginning of his career, you're very surprised he has made it as far as he has and become as good as he is. Why?
Look, the fact it was easy to, he was so precocious that I was watching a 17 and 18 year old compete against fully grown men. Juan Diaz has shown as he's developed, especially in his last fight against Michael Cassidy's, not only a plan A, but a plan B. He's not just a simple pressure fighter. He can box in semicircles. He uses his jab well. He has fast hands. He can throw combinations and counterpunch. He's developed into a multi-dimensional threat. The only thing he's missing, knockout power.
Will the absence of knockout power, Emmanuel, penalize him against Marquez tonight?
I do not think so. I don't think his power is that bad. It's not no devastating one punch punches a pound, but he punches, I think, good, and he punches often enough, and he punches in bunches, so I think that would make up for that. I think that may be his advantage going down the stretch, is to just apply pressure, because fighting a technical fight, I think Marquez is just too much for him. So he's going to have to set a tempo, and the volume of punches is going to have to be to his advantage.
Indeed, that's the heart of the matter, because the challenge facing young Diaz tonight is how to outwork and out-energize the man who just might be the most skilled prize fighter in the sport.
Marquez seizing the advantage in the center of the ring. Here comes the blood, and here comes the crowd on their feet.
Yo voy a demostrar y a probar que yo soy el mejor peleador libra por libra. Juan Diaz es 50% mexicano y 50% americano. Y yo soy 100% mexicano.
Uppercut for Marquez. Left hook. Marquez looking to knock his man out.
That's his Sunday punch. When he catches you with a hook clean, you gotta go.
Diaz es un peleador joven, un peleador fuerte. Pero lo que tengo yo, la experiencia, la fuerza y las ganas también de salir adelante, de ganar.
His face is ripped open and he wants to fight up.
They trade shots. What a fight.
Dicen que el knockout llegó solo, pero también hay veces que hay que buscarlo y nosotros vamos a poner todo para que el knockout llegue.
Coming to the ring.
Juan Manuel Dinamita Marquez.
Max, in both his first and second fights against Manny Pacquiao, he won more rounds than Pacquiao. Do you think it's his holy grail to be seen as the number one fighter in the sport?
Yeah, let me make the case that it is, in fact, Marquez who is the best pound-for-pound fighter in the sport. Manny Pacquiao has that distinction partly based on his win over Marquez. I would say many, if not most, in the hardcore boxing community feel Marquez may have won both those fights. Then Pacquiao moved up to lightweight, beat David Diaz. No one considered Diaz a top three or four lightweight. And then moved up to welterweight and beat Oscar De La Hoya, a superstar. But no one considered Oscar a top three or four welterweight. Meanwhile, Marquez moved up to lightweight, knocked out the reigning lineal champion and certainly one of the best 135-pounders, Casamayor, and here tonight faces something Pacquiao's never faced. And in his prime, 135-pounder, among the very best in the world, young, energetic, bigger, and an excellent fighter.
And Emmanuel, if he can get past the potential nightmare of Diaz tonight, he wants to fight the winner of Pacquiao Hatton at 140. Is he really big enough to move up another 5 pounds, or would that be tempting fate?
Well, I think the main 140-pounder that he's going after is the guy he's been fighting so much at 26 and 30. So that switches Manny Pacquiao. So I would say we'll be fine. But Ricky Hatton is another thing. Ricky is a physically much stronger and tougher guy. I think Ricky, even though he may not punch as precision and be a little rough with his style of fighting, I think it would be a little too much for him probably. I don't think he could outbox Ricky that easy.
Two great fighters ready in the ring. Let's go to Michael Buffer for the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Toyota Center, Houston, Texas, Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions is proud to present the main event of the evening, champion versus champion, sponsored by Tecate, Cerveza con Carácter, and Southwest Airlines, no hidden fees. This contest, scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBA, the vacant WBO, and the IBO and Ring Magazine Lightweight Championship of the World. Sanctioned by the Texas Department of Licensing and Regulation, Executive Director William Kunz. At ringside, the three judges scoring, Max DeLuca, Queen Ford, and Levi Martinez. And inside the ring, your referee in charge of the action, U.S. Army First Sergeant retired Rafael Ramos. And now, for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world from Houston, Texas, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Fighting out of the blue corner, wearing blue, officially weighing 134 one-half pounds, this two-time world champion has a professional record consisting of 34 victories, including 17 knockouts with only one defeat. From Houston, Texas, the reigning, defending, IBO lightweight champion of the world, El Torito, Juan Baby Bull Diaz. And fighting out of the red corner, wearing silver with red, official weight 134 one-quarter pounds, a three-time world champion and future Hall of Famer, has a professional record of 49 victories, including 36 knockouts, 4 defeats, and 1 bout even. De Ciudad de Mexico, the reigning, defending, Ring Magazine lightweight champion of the world, Juan Manuel Dinamita
Okay, guys, use the pre fine instructions. Recibiste las instrucciones. Protect yourself. Protégete todo el tiempo. Buena suerte. Good luck. Let's go.
Who is the best lightweight in the world? We're about to find out.
Did and bringing Rocky Juarez home to the draw with Chris John in the first fight. Now he goes to work again because Shields also trains Juan Diaz. Marquez's trainer, Nacho Beristain, was the man who handled Oscar De La Hoya in his disastrous outing against Manny Pacquiao. Already the pressure from Diaz begins. Good straight left hand by Diaz and the chopping left hook in the corner. And another left hook backs up Marquez against the ropes. Marquez hasn't found the counter-punching rhythm quite yet.
As a matter of fact, Marquez has not been able to land to me one clean blow yet. And whereas I think Diaz has landed about three or four punches at this stage.
Now Marquez begins to try to extend his jab. So far seems just a bit off balance in the face of Diaz's aggression. Diaz showing respect, but ripping Marquez with another left hook. Three body shots from Marquez. Diaz goes in with the right hand. This is going to be a hellacious war.
Unlike a lot of fights between a younger and older fighter, in this case, the early rounds seem to favor Diaz, where he can take over with his energy and volume punching. Marquez relies on precision counter punches, which may tell later in the fight.
Marquez works his way into the fight. Remember, down three times against Pacquiao in the first round of the first fight. Down in the second round of the second fight. Had trouble early against Casamayor. But in the middle rounds, he finds the rhythm, adjusts his game, and begins to go to work technically.
What's impressive to me right now is Diaz's defense. He's been able to pick most of Marquez's punches and has found a way of getting, particularly his little short left jab through, to hit Marquez for the most part. I thought this is what we would see starting about the fourth round, but not in the first round.
See, what I just saw over the last 15 or 20 seconds was Marquez land a couple of clean shots and then block everything Diaz had to throw over the, you know, by the ropes. Maybe he's already making adjustments.
Well, Diaz's great brain power serves him well, not just in the college classroom. He's used it throughout his learning curve in the ring. And Marquez just might be the smartest fighter in the sport. So you're looking at great intellect as well as great athletic talent.
Not to mention the well-known cultural Mexican tradition of willing to mix it up.
And are they ever? What a big left hook by Diaz. Marquez trying to fire back, lands a right cross and a left hook. Round one is an all-out war. And they taunt each other.
Everything is okay. When he throws his jab, you throw your right hand or your uppercut. Where's the grease? Where's the Vaseline? Everything's okay. But he closed you up. Step back and go to the sides.
Don't get up high. Stay down low. Use the jab. Get close. Keep your punches going, all right?
Okay, seconds out.
Let's go. Step in.
What a sizzling round one. CompuBox numbers. Marquez 29 out of 95. Diaz 31 out of 104. The 95 punches thrown by Marquez, the most ever thrown in a round by Marquez in a fight tracked by CompuBox. Translation, he was forced to play Diaz's game.
Absolutely. And when Diaz is exchanging, notice Diaz is punching straight through the middle with punches where he's really exerting his weight. And even though they weighed in the same, and I guess tonight Marquez weighed in more, but I just see the natural strength more with Diaz. And he's punching in a manner where he's forcing Marquez to back up by pushing his punches straight forward and pushing his weight at the same time.
And by the way, with the sole exception of his one loss in the Campbell fight, Diaz's stamina across the long course of the fight has always been amazing to behold. So don't expect much of a slowdown. If anything, if he gets his chance, he might crank it up a little more. But now the pace slows a little bit in the second round as Marquez begins to add more variety to his game. You saw the left-hand uppercut. Body shots by Diaz. I get the hunch that Marquez is going to need to stay off the ropes, Emmanuel.
Yes, and I don't think he's going to do that. And the way that Diaz is punching, he's got his head down more, where he's getting better leverage in the exchanges, and Marquez's head is up more.
And this crowd is on its feet already, and they may be on their feet all the way.
You notice Diaz is not throwing that many hooks. He's shooting his punches straight, where he can maximize his strength.
Big left hook staggers Marquez. Marquez in trouble and trying to fight his way out of it.
And we've seen this from Marquez before when he's stunned, and he was stunned there. His instinct is to fire right back. Maybe the truest mark of a real champion.
But he's in with a bigger man this time, and I can see the difference in the strength right here.
If Diaz had world-class power for the weight, Marquez might have been gone right there. It was an unbelievable shot. But if Marquez continues to fight back.
His punching power is not that bad. That would, you know, he still may possibly stop Marquez, at least knock him down.
You saw that instinct that I mentioned from Morales and Barrera in this last featherweight golden era, and I think Marquez has the same thing inside him.
In fact, if you wanted to find a comparison for what round one looked like, it looked like a round out of a Morales-Barrera fight.
And so does this one.
I like Diaz's defense for the most part, which I'm surprised.
They're both going to land more than 30 punches in the round. Big left hook by Diaz, straight right hand by Marquez. Good left hook by Marquez on the top of Diaz's head. Diaz jabbing and hunting. Marquez going to the body and coming back up. Missed the right hand. What a round.
To give me a boxing round this round, okay? Okay? I want you to relax from it all, okay? Now listen, don't let this guy out-jab you, okay? See, this whole thing is, he's trying to out-jab you, okay? Don't let him out-jab you. Look, you're coming up a little bit too high. We gotta stay down, and we gotta move to keep the head moving, okay? But everything else is good. When you get close, keep sticking with that jab, go to the body, okay? But look, this round here, I really want you to concentrate on that jab this round, okay?
Yeah, we say Diaz driving in, as we call him, left hook right there, and had probably more effect than it would have had, except because he had him back and back. And he's maximizing his weight on every punch by lunging forward as he punches.
Copy box numbers in the second round. Marquez 34 out of 94. Diaz 30 out of 98. So if the first round was the largest number of punches Marquez has ever thrown in a copy box counted round, the second round was the second largest number of punches ever thrown in a copy box counted round. They're still basically playing Diaz's game.
Marquez is a very intelligent fighter, though. If there is any mistakes in Diaz's arsenal, you can be sure that Marquez is going to find him out as the fight goes on.
Well, I think very intelligent is an understatement.
Yes.
He's a supremely intelligent fighter.
Yes.
He's blessed with excellent reflexes and very good punching power, but you have to wonder about those reflexes at the age of 35.
Yes. And particularly given the wars he's been in. And a guy's had as many terrific fights against great opponents as Marquez has had. Every once in a while, they go off the diving board all at once, but he's looked really good in the first couple of rounds against a guy who's looked just a tiny bit better.
Yeah, but the guy's putting a lot of pressure. I don't think Marquez, this pressure is going to probably negate a lot of his counterpunching better because it's making him fight at a faster pace than he likes to fight at.
Diaz, he's going to have to watch out for the uppercut. Marquez threw the uppercut from a little too far away. He's going to have to get closer to do it right. Good straight jabs by Marquez there, momentarily stopping Diaz in his tracks. And tracks they are, as Juan stalks and stalks. Four-punch combination by Diaz.
This is the Juan Diaz that had the boxing world buzzing before his loss to Nate Campbell.
What a will. What determination. Good luck took by Diaz.
Marquez is landing punches, but the way that Diaz is piling in with his weight is making his punches look more effective because he's forcing Marquez to lose his balance. But even though Marquez is landing punches just as good sometimes.
Good right hand by Marquez. Right behind Diaz's guard and on the ear. Real fighters love this. They love this kind of competition. A lot of Marquez advocates thought this might be man against boy. So far, it's been man on man in a fight for man only. Monday night, a brand new event, the BNP Paribas Showdown for the Billie Jean King Cup. One night of live women's tennis featuring the Williams sisters, Yelena Yankovic and Anna Ivanovic.
You've got to throw the punches. Throw the punches, make him miss. Come on. Uppercut with the left shot. And finish off with a hook to the liver.
Okay? Keep using that good jab, though, okay? Stay with that good jab. Double and triple that jab. Every now and then fade it and come right back. Both hands, okay? Let's dig that body.
Here you see Diaz coming in, pushing his punches forward with full force, and also you see punches coming back from Marquez, which are counter punches, but it don't create the excitement because he's not forcing Diaz to back, but he's still landing clean, effective punches.
Combi box numbers through round three. Marquez 91 out of 268. Diaz 87 out of 281. Harold, how do you have it so far?
Look at you. Three rounds to nothing. 30 to 27. Juan Diaz. Jim, one quick thing about our last fight. I absolutely can't remember the last time I saw three judges score a draw. Very, very rare. Back to this fight. Juan Diaz keeps walking them down, landing clean, hard, effective shots. And when it gets Marquez on the ropes, Marquez seems to lose his head and stand there and slug with Diaz. And that's how Diaz wants to fight. Juan Diaz landing more clean shots, just like he's doing right there. 3-0 Diaz.
You know, I understand that score. And Diaz is imposing his kind of fight. But I'll tell you the truth, guys. I think Marquez is landing the harder punches.
Well, I think he might be a harder puncher, but of course, Diaz, as we pointed out, is by nature the bigger man and more of a natural lightweight. Emmanuel, what is Marquez going to do to take away Diaz's left hook, which is landing with ferocious regularity?
I've been impressed by the left hook, which I'm surprised, especially, you know, most of the guys from Mexico block left hooks very well. But I think he's going to have to try to just block the punch and counter punch at the exact same time. And I don't know if he can do that. He needs to, whenever he sees Marquez, I mean Diaz throwing a hook, and he's a block it and shoot his counter hook at the exact same time.
Diaz has been brilliant so far at finding those moments when Marquez's right hand is slightly dropped. He's landed several plus left hooks.
Yeah, and he gets maximum level. He hunches his body forward in a Joe Frazier type style, where his left hook has tremendous force because he has his weight leaning right into the position where he can load up on the left hook.
But look at the comeback combination by Marquez. A four-punch, counter-punch combination. Awesome stuff.
Why should a fight like this even be scored? Just let them fight to the finish.
Okay? Come on, I need that head side to side here more. Okay? Listen, relax and take it. Relax, okay? Everything is going good for you, okay? Listen, you gotta use the jab. The jab is the most important thing you have. But you gotta step in with it. Don't fall in with it, okay? Okay? No, everything is going good, baby. Everything is going good. Just keep that head.
Where's the Vaseline? Where's the Vaseline? Come on, you put some punches in there. Put your punches in there. He's opening his mouth already.
Here you see Diaz land his beautiful left hook. Evidently, Marquez cannot feel the left hook when it's coming. He's reaching out for it as if it was maybe a jab coming in, and instead he's getting caught with that left hook continually.
In round four, Marquez gained just a little bit of an edge in CompuBox numbers, 38 out of 96 as opposed to 30 of 86 for Diaz. And for the first time in the fight, Harold Letterman sees a round in Marquez's favor.
I also thought Marquez landed the most effective punches towards the end of that round.
I agree with you, Matthew. He just doesn't get the credit for it because, you know, he doesn't move Diaz back, where when Diaz lands a punch, he always forces Marquez's head and his body to move back. But Marquez is landing a lot of clean, effective combinations, particularly at the end of the round.
Diaz is trying to follow in the footsteps of boxing greats like Jake LaMotta, Jeff Fennec, and others who were great pressure fighters. Even though they weren't big punchers, but they were able to establish themselves with their volume of punching and their physical strength.
Diaz again, imposing his will against Marquez on the ropes, and catches him again with a left hook as Marquez steps away. Now Marquez will look to land a 3 or 4 punch combination, and he nails Diaz with 2 uppercuts in a row, both from the left side. Straight right hand down the pipe by Diaz, lands twice in a row. Whoever throws more body punches may ultimately be the winner in the fight.
Well, I tell you what, this is going to be a tough fight right here.
Another huge left hook by Diaz.
I mean, these guys are fighting at a pace and putting such mustard on each shot and fighting at a skill level. You rarely see all those elements combined.
Big
in a
body
fight.
Shot by Marquez.
You know, referee Rafael Ramos has not had to break these guys up for one clinch at all that I can remember.
I didn't even know he was in the ring.
No, they're just fighting their way straight through the fight.
You know, not to say it's quite on that level yet, but in certain ways, it's reminiscent of Corrales and Castillo. No
the number
clinches.
Of bombs that are being landed.
I guess not, but no clinches, a fast pace, hard shots, high skill level. Unclear who will ultimately impose their will.
That fight was in 2003, I believe, on our competitor network, Showtime. One difference, maybe those guys were slightly heavier punches, but neither of them had the volume that these guys are producing tonight. Good left hook by Diaz again, and a right hand at the end of the round by Marquez. And there's blood above the corner of Marquez's right eye. And I was just about to say, Emmanuel, whose face can hold up? Whose features will hold up under all this leather?
Let's go to the head.
Por favor.
Please. Where's the grease? Where's the Vaseline?
Juan,
wait. Let me work the cut. I'm winning. You're winning, but very little. By very little. You see, the referee looks like he changed sides on him.
Let's go.
Marquez has been cut in that same spot before. Yes. Yes. Against both Manny Pacquiao and Joel Casamayor. Nacho Beristain has worked that cut before, and he's working it again tonight. Diaz was cut badly in the Campbell fight. But other than that, his features have held up very well despite his non-stop high-pressure style in other fights. Another big left hook by Diaz. I mentioned the body shot disparity. I believe it's Marquez, really, who's thrown more body shots early and is landing them at a high rate. Blood begins to trickle again from the cut just outside Marquez's right eye. There, Diaz got in a solid body shot against the ropes. Marquez is beginning to become more conscious of trying to block Diaz's left hook. Diaz is adjusting by going to the body instead.
If Marquez is not setting a trap when he's retreating to the ropes, that's a very good sign for Diaz.
But I was very impressed at the point that you mentioned, Jim, that he's been able to neutralize Diaz's left hooks lately. He has not been hitting any of those left hooks. And that's a sign of a very intelligent fighter. Marquez, even the crowd is excited, but Marquez is landing most of the cleaner blows in those exchanges there.
Diaz eats a hard right hand, lands a hard right hand, takes a hard right hand. Crowd rises to its feet again.
Look, don't let this guy rest, okay? Don't let him rest, don't let him rest. Okay? Look, you're not stepping with that jab though, baby. Okay? Give me a deep one. Deep one. Let him out slow. Again, deep one. Let him out slow. Look.
What is it? Seventh round. It's the seventh round. Don't go to the rope, son. Just move your head. Don't let him build. Don't let him build, okay? What's the Vaseline? I want yellow Vaseline. Don't expose yourself, Juan. Come on, in the center of the ring. Throw the combinations, beautiful combinations. And then move.
Can anybody believe we're already halfway through the fight? What a pace. Power punches through six rounds. Marquez 128 out of 290. Diaz 122 out of 369. I mentioned the body shots. The advantage there so far, Marquez, he's landed 30 to 23 for Diaz. Harold, that's not really how fights are scored by judges. How do you have it?
No, Jim, 4 rounds to 2. 58-56, one Diaz. Jim, one Manuel Marquez really ought to stay off them ropes. When he goes on the ropes, Juan Diaz just pummels him like you're watching right here. When a fight goes into the center of the ring, Juan Manuel Marquez does very, very well. But he ought to stay off the ropes. He's given Diaz the advantage of that effective aggressiveness and using his size by going up on the ropes. 4-2, Juan Diaz.
Here's an amazing statistic, guys. Through six rounds of this fight, and despite the fact that Marquez twice went 12 rounds with Manny Pacquiao, Juan Diaz has already thrown more power punches against Juan Manuel Marquez than anybody has ever thrown against him in a 12-round fight. Already.
Standards of this fight, Diaz took a breather in the sixth, something that Ronnie Shields noted in the corner. and told him to correct.
Lonnie hadn't had to work quite as hard here as he did in the Rocky Juarez-Chris Dunn fight that preceded this. And he'll be trying to steer his man down the stretch for sure. Straight right hands landing for Juan Manuel Marquez. Left hook lands again for Diaz. Left hook, left hook, body shot. Left hook to the body, all by Juan Diaz. Now Marquez tries to come back.
I don't know if Marquez is going to be able to maintain all the way through, you know, because he throws a lot of punches, but the fights with Pacquiao, he had a lot of in-between time. Diaz is pushing him a lot more.
And his mouth is open, Emmanuel, and he's breathing past his mouth guard. And it looks as though the stamina advantage is beginning to show for the baby bull.
Marquez has fought a bit with his mouth open since the third round. The pace is something, as you noted, Jim, that he's not used to.
But he's landing a lot of clean blows. You don't get the reaction from the crowd that's whenever Diaz is, but he's landing a lot of clean blows still.
Especially in the middle of the ring, as yeah. Harold mentioned.
Yeah.
Two straight right hands by Marquez. Two more big left hooks by Diaz. Drives Marquez back against the ropes. Lands a straight right hand of his own. Marquez trying to counter again. Diaz keeping the pressure on. He listened to Ronnie between rounds. He's not going to let the Mexican rest.
Everything, watch his face.
Nice smart, Juan.
Listen, I still got to stay close to him, but look, all we got to do, Juan, you still, in the inside, we got to move his leg. Got to move your, got to move your head in the inside, okay?
Okay.
Just move your head, give it a deep breath. No, you're boxing good, okay. Son. Okay? You're boxing good. But
okay.
Move in the middle, get to the middle. In the middle. You're beating it down. Don't go to the ropes. That's on his favors. In the middle, you're beating him.
Here you can see the intensity of the furious exchanges that they have, and you see the punches are landing. Short punches, sweat flying, shows the type of a fight. Just a lot of excitement, a lot of hard punches.
Copy box numbers in the seventh. Marquez 35 out of 70, landing half his blows. Diaz 34 out of 91. Again, they're still playing mostly Diaz's game. And that's showing up on Harold Lederman's scorecard. You've heard the crowd. You've seen the energy. In January, it was a tremendous crowd in Staples Center in Los Angeles for Shane Mosley's whacking of Antonio Margarito. Last Saturday night, big crowds in Madison Square Garden and Youngstown, Ohio for Miguel Cotto and Kelly Pavlik. Now this, economic conditions are helping to bring boxing back to its roots and fans are responding. And now there's a cut outside Diaz's right eye.
From the left uppercut from Marquez, which has been maybe his most effective punch.
Along with the straight right hand. So they're equal in cuts now. Marquez is having a strong rally in the first minute of the eighth round. There comes the uppercut again. Twice in a row.
He's found a home with that left uppercut between the gloves.
Diaz isn't landing many of these.
No.
But he's asserting his energy again. Good job of blocking punches there by the baby bull. That cut could pose a problem between rounds for Joe Chavez again. You saw the job that Chavez did with Rocky Juarez's cut in the first fight. He'll have to go to work on Diaz rounds.
Same thing as, you know, Marquez is fighting for the pride of his country. You know, even though they're both supposed to be Mexicans, right now, Marquez is saying that he would die in the ring and leave all the blood that he has in his body for his country in this fight. Because he considers Diaz a half Mexican. He's American Mexican.
What action.
This is amazing.
Marquez is a good defensive fighter, but Diaz overwhelms his defense, overtaxes it with the sheer volume of his punches. Even as Marquez sharpshoots and continues to land the flusher, harder shots.
And
And as the blood flows, the urgency level rises.
And you can see now it looks like the expression on Diaz's face has changed somewhat. And Marquez's confidence level is starting to grow now.
Diaz did not respond well to the cut against Nate Campbell. He's cut in a similar kind of dire way here against Marquez.
Well, we told you how Marquez adjusts and
Diaz got caught with a left hook and he looks stunned.
25 seconds to go. The great technician find a way? Diaz with a left hook to back him off. That left hook was about as clutch a punch as Diaz could possibly have thrown.
And you know, Marquez is an experienced fighter, and he can handle getting into trouble, but I don't know if Diaz can handle that, because he has not had that type of experience.
Everybody's up.
Okay, Juan. Hey, what was it? I'm a punch. A punch? Listen, you're not moving your head, son. Okay? Look, don't worry about that cut. The cut is okay. All right? Joe got the cut. Now, listen. Give me that mouthpiece. Sorry. Give me a drink. Listen, you got to use the jab, all right? Listen, use your feints on him now, okay? Don't give him too much distance, though. Okay? Okay? Don't stand right in front of this man.
Here you see Marquez mixing up his punches, punches to the outside and between the gloves. I think that left uppercut between the gloves right there was a shot that caused the cut. You can see the blood just start to spurt as soon as he landed that left uppercut. And here is the left hook that he catches with the head, which he just simply didn't see the punch. And it's a punch that hurts you, is always one you didn't see. Because he thought he had blocked it, but it came in the back of the gloves. It still came through. Now, for the first time, the test is going to be how can Diaz handle adversity.
The eighth round was a huge round for Juan Manuel Marquez. 40 out of 85 by CompuBox numbers. Diaz landed only 18 out of 70. Harold Letterman's scorecard begins to tighten. Marquez making his patented mid-round rush.
He's the heavier-handed fighter, and he's the more accurate puncher. And it's starting to take its toll on Diaz.
Another CompuBox milestone. Marquez has now landed more punches in the fight than he's ever landed in a fight counted by CompuBox. I got a feeling they're going to smash every possible CompuBox record for these two fighters tonight.
While they smash each other's faces.
Exactly. What an amazing adjustment Marquez made, Emmanuel, about the third or fourth round to find that uppercut and start to hammer away at it with two and three uppercuts at a time.
Very smart, smart fighter. Great adjustments. I thought this time he would be watching, but as he's turning around, he's back in the fight, and Diaz is starting to grow up right now. Seeming a little bit. You know, it's interesting, when Diaz had his first professional fight, he was in Mexico, he met Marquez, and they became friends for that night. And Marquez said he never would dream at that time, especially being that he was only 16, that he would end up fighting with Diaz.
He said he was such a nice kid, so warm, so personable. They're taunting each other in the ring. Great left hook by Diaz. He's trying to turn the tide through the sheer force of will.
In between all of us, the referee still is not to have a big one. Christmas means if anyone gets seriously hurt in this fight, they're probably going to get stopped.
All credit to the referee.
Because they
don't know the clinch. When he stops it, it'll be the first thing he's done in the fight.
Though Marquez is the much more experienced, in fact, it's Diaz who's had more experience fighting at this pace over the course of the fight.
And he's 10 years younger. And he's fighting in his hometown. And he's supposedly the stronger man.
And he's hurt.
A huge uppercut. Down goes Diaz.
Well, let's see, it's all because he doesn't know how to clinch.
Can he make it out of the ring? 35 seconds to go. A very brave Juan Diaz will probably go back to fighting.
A spirit fighter would probably clinch, but I don't think that's what he's going to do.
And look at Marquez go to the body. Look at him go to the body and try to set up the finisher. What a right hand, and that will be that.
What you just saw was a really good young fighter knocked out by a great old fighter.
Absolutely.
And you're pound for pound number one.
Maybe. Marquez. Just might
no,
be.
No, that's what you said, and you have good grounds to say that.
Well, let me say this. That's as sensational as any performance Manny Pacquiao's ever produced, for sure. No discredit to Pacquiao, who is great. Marquez is just as great. Knockdown. Okay. Here's another look at the first knockdown, Emmanuel.
Right hand, but what amazed me was the precision and the accuracy of the punches from Marquez. He didn't miss too many punches, and he was punching from all angles, even as he was twisting and turning. The mark of an experienced fighter.
A straight right hand, and then the uppercut produced that first knockdown. The second knockdown is really almost a formality on a brilliant right uppercut.
The one thing that Marquez
set up
did,
by the body shots.
Marquez mixed up his punches. He threw punches over the top and then he threw punches up underneath.
The sheer professionalism of the knockout, an amazing thing. And if ever you wanted an example of how to finish by going to the body first and setting it up upstairs, that was it. Textbook stuff.
Well, he was a favorite going into the fight, and he proved it, to say the experts right.
Well, I was speaking to one expert last night who picked Marquez, and at the end of the day, his rationale was he's just a better fighter. And I think this fight showed that.
Yeah, I thought that Diaz would have been able to pull it off. In the beginning of the fight, it showed that way, but Marquez came back and turned the fight around. Very, very smart fighter.
Let's hear the particulars on the knockout from Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we give the official time, a round of applause for these two blood and guts lightweight warriors in this ring here tonight in Houston. The official time, 2:40, round number 9. The winner by knockout victory, Steel Ring Magazine, world champion, and now WBA, WBO, and IBO unified lightweight champion of the world, Juan Manuel Dinamita.
Final CompuBox numbers and an astonishing show by both fighters. Marquez landing 36 more, throwing 49 fewer, landing at a significantly higher percentage, ultimately picking Diaz apart with the brilliance of his offensive repertoire. Power punches. Marquez landing 29 more. Look at that. Juan Diaz threw 500 power shots. Marquez landing 47%. And many times we've told you over the years, if a fighter is landing half or close to half of his power shots, he is going to win the fight. Let's go to Max Kellerman now with the winner, Juan Manuel Marquez.
The great Juan Manuel Marquez, congratulations on a terrific fight and a great win. How did you knock out Juan Diaz?
Bueno, nosotros veníamos a trabajar combinaciones en el centro del ring, boxear. Es un golpeador que tira bastantes golpes, pero bueno, nosotros con nuestro cabeceo y a la vez los contragolpes nos sirvieron.
We came to work, we came to box to throw punches. He's a fighter who throws a lot of punches, but with our head movement and our body movement, we were able to evade those.
He looked like early he was imposing his kind of fight on you. Is that what you felt was happening?
Sí, la pelea iba pareja en los primeros tres rounds. Él se estaba queriendo imponer tirando sus combinaciones con velocidad. Pero no, nosotros supimos manejar la cintura, quitando unos golpes de Juan Díaz, que tira combinaciones bastante rápidas, pero nosotros veníamos preparados a todo.
It felt pretty even the first three rounds. Yes, he was throwing a lot of punches, but with our body moving, our head moving, we were taking punches off, we were picking them off, and I thought we had it.
It seemed that though you were doing better and better throughout the fight, The knockout was sudden. Did you feel him weakening? Did you feel that the knockout was coming?
Sentimos que desde el cuarto, quinto round estaba aflojando con los golpes al cuerpo. Bueno, yo creo que vimos el momento oportuno para noquear y así llegó.
Since the fourth and fifth round, we saw that the punches were making him tender to the body, and fortunately the knockout came.
Okay, the business at lightweight seems finished. There's no dispute possible that you're not only the lightweight champion, but the best lightweight in the world. Is your business at lightweight done? Do you plan on moving up, or do you plan on staying put and fighting some of the junior lightweights who are moving up?
Yo creo que es más factible, en vez de bajar, vamos a subir y retar al mejor peleador que hay ahorita, que puede ser Mayweather.
Instead of going down or staying the weight, we're going to go up and meet Mayweather, which would be the best pound for pound.
Floyd Mayweather, what makes you think Floyd Mayweather will fight you?
Porque es un gran peleador. Pacquiao ya no quiere pelear conmigo. Él dicen que es el mejor libra por libra, pero no. Yo quiero pelear con el mejor libra por libra, que es Floyd Mayweather.
He says he's the best pound per pound, Pacquiao, but he really doesn't want to fight with me. So I want to fight the best pound per pound, and that would be Mayweather.
Who would want to fight with you, Juan? Congratulations again. Excuse Juan Diaz. First, congratulations on a tremendous performance, even in a loss. What happened in those middle rounds?
I got caught with a good punch, and you know, I got cut, and then once that cut was, that blood was in my eye, I couldn't do anything about it. It just, you know, it was in my eye, it was bothering me. I couldn't really see the punches that Marquez was throwing at me.
The same thing happened against Nate Campbell. You cut and were not able to adjust. Did you not learn anything from the Campbell fight? Is it just a situation where there's nothing you feel you can do with a cut like that?
Well, I did learn. I kept fighting. You know, I kept fighting my heart out. I kept pushing forward. I felt that I was doing better in the inside. And then he caught me with a good punch. What can I say?
Because of your instincts as a fighter, it seemed when you were hurt, you didn't clinch. Were you so out of it that you didn't think to clinch? Did your aggressive instincts simply take over?
Yeah, my aggressive instincts took over. I felt that, if I show him that I'm hurt, he was going to jump on me. So I said, hey, the hell with it. You know, I'm gonna go for it. Whether I get him, knock him down, or he knocks me down, I'm a fighter.
Well, the hell with it attitude doesn't always suit you, but it always works out for the fans, Juan. Thanks for a great performance.
Thank you for having me, Max, and HBO. Thanks for the love and support, Houston.
One last thought. This was the best lightweight fight we've seen since Diego Corrales and Jose Luis Castillo had arguably the greatest fight of all time. And I don't think it's coincidence that WB this and IB that, whatever, this was for the lineal, the real lightweight championship of the world. That trinket isn't not only a trinket, it's not so easy to come by. When that is on the line frequently, it is the very best fighters in the world we see going at it. We saw it here tonight. Great fight.
All right, thanks very much, Max. Totally agreed from this end. Emmanuel, February 28th is a little bit early to proclaim something the fight of the year, but good luck to the rest of the sport producing something that good or that significant. What are your thoughts?
Well, if the rest of the year can continue the way the Shane Mosley and Margarito fight and this fight has started off, we're off to a good start this year, and I'm looking forward to the Ricky Haddon and Pacquiao fight. So it looks like we're going to have maybe not a volume of punch, I mean, a fight like we've had in the past, but the quality of the fights this year, I think, are going to be fantastic.
Yeah, and poetically enough, you saw how in the very first fight between Rocky Juarez and Chris John tonight, all three judges scored it a draw, and Harold Letterman said that was unusual. It was absolutely perfect tonight in a sense that in this fight, Max DeLuca had Diaz leading by two. Dwayne Ford had Marquez leading by two. Levi Martinez had it even. The fight was a dead even draw on the scorecards at the moment when Marquez applied the clincher. A brilliant performance by Juan Manuel Marquez against a spirited and energetic challenge from Juan Diaz. And I just feel lucky we were here.
It was a great night here, and the fans got the minutes worth. Even when you lose the way that Diaz lost tonight, And the way that Rocky Warriors fought, the fans here have to be proud of them, the hometown people, because they went out like Warriors. One with a draw, one with a loss, but they fought very gallant tonight.
Yeah, you said it all. If the rest of the year can go like this, we are going to have some fun in 2009. So thanks very much for being with us for this live doubleheader in Houston tonight. If you've missed any part of this telecast, you can catch it in its entirety on HBO tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. and on HBO 2 tomorrow afternoon at 4:30 p.m. and Tuesday night at 11:30 p.m. This Monday night, it's live women's tennis featuring the Williams sisters, Yelena Yankovic and Anna Ivanovic, all competing in the BNP Paribas Showdown for the Billie Jean King Cup. And next Saturday night, Boxing After Dark returns with an action-packed triple header. Knockout artists James Kirkland and Joel Julio will meet in the main event, should be explosive, while Robert Guerrero and Victor Ortiz round out this three-fight card, fighting in separate bouts. Next on HBO, stay tuned for 10,000 BC. And now for our entire HBO crew, I'm Jim Lampley, saying goodnight from Houston, Texas.
This has been a presentation of HBO Sports.